I'm Dr. Reed. I'm the Chief Medical Officer here at Wakana, one of the co-founders. I want to welcome all of you. Today we have my business partners that are also involved in this CBD fitness virtual party. Dr. DJ Roz, you heard her sounds, you hear more of her music. We have Queen Neff, who will be doing our mindfulness meditation and yoga. We have Dr. Tyus Crawford, our family practitioner. I believe she'll be doing lower body, and Minister Ernestine Davis in the house. She's going to be doing our upper body and core. First though, I want to tell you how I personally use these products before our warm up. You know, every single night I use our gummies. Our gummies are a product that really help you sleep, you know, and this is not a sales meeting, but what this is we are really empowering you to know that there are products that you can use holistically and naturally, and organic products here at Wakana that will assist in a restful sleep. If you don't sleep, your immune system doesn't reset. If you don't get the inflammation down in your body can't heal. So CBD is a natural ingredient from the cannabis plant, yes, but it comes from hemp. It doesn't get you high. It gets you whole and healthy. So every single night I take a gummy, and every single night I use a cream, a salve, a topical, and I put it in areas that are sore. I work out every day. I'm training to compete. It's going to be a long time coming, but I'm still in the gym all the time. And so I use the salve every night so that I can sleep and I won't be in pain. So I put this salve on my piriformis. I'm having an issue with sciatica right now. I put it on that left shoulder and I put it on my right knee. I injured my right knee skiing in 2009. So that's what I do every night. In the morning, I wake up. We have a product you can put in your water. Can you imagine that? It's a water-soluble product. It's a great product for those who are on the go. You just drop it in your water. You drop it in your smoothie. You're good to go. Gives you energy. CBD also helps to increase your metabolism. So you're looking to lose weight. You can do that as well. So we're going to get ready to warm it up. The warm-up is going to be a little different. It's going to incorporate some kickboxing moves. It's going to open up our hips, get our abs ready, get our arms ready, and get our legs ready. Great. So DJ Roz, are you out there? And hopefully everyone can see me. Can everyone see me?
Yes.
Wonderful. Let's start out with just some bob and weave. Just a bob and weave. Just like in boxing. Warming up those legs. And weave. Bob and weave. You got it. It's 10, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 2, and 1. We're in a squat, and we're in a front punch. We're in a squat, just a nice front punch.
Dr. Rita!
Yes?
Get you, Dr. Rita.
What?
Who get you, girl?
Protecting your face. It's kick. It's kick. Nice strong arm. in and up. You're in a squat position. Here we go. It's 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box yourself. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take it up for 2, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and front. It's 10, 9, you got it, 8, it's 7, 6, it's 5, it's 4, don't start it over, please don't start it over. That should be the end of that song. Hey! Hey, Dr. Roz, are you starting it over? Good job, good job. Were you starting the music over?
Yeah, because you were still going.
Oh, no. Yes. Just remember to play it one time. That's it, one time. Thank you, Dr. Roz. Thank you so much. I think that I am going to bring up lower body. Is that right? And I'm bringing Dr. Tyus up first. Is that right? Do want to talk about one more product, and that product is our broad spectrum products. Those are products for those who have random drug screens at their job. So we have products for everyone. We have a product that has less than 0.0% THC. Again, these are amazing products that help you reduce inflammation, reduce pain, increase your metabolism, lose weight, and give you energy and sleep at the same time. So Dr. Tyus Crawford is a family practitioner. I met her 6 years ago when we were all trying to get healthy. I was over 211 pounds at the time. She was struggling with hypertension, and Dr. Tyus Crawford is a marathon runner. She's a beast, man. Triathlons, marathons, you name it. Dr. Tyus Crawford, are you out there?
Yes, good morning, everyone. Good morning. So yes, this morning I'm gonna do lower body. And just to make sure you get proper sleep as best you can. I do too take the gummies, and you wanna get at least 7 to 9 hours of sleep. Try to make that in your schedule. And that rejuvenates your body. It calms down your mind so you can get through the rest of the day as you need to. And make sure you get plenty of water throughout the day. When you're exercising, you want to drink a little bit more every 30 minutes or so. So we're going to do lower body, and we're going to try to do 2 sets. And then at the end, if you have a wall, close to a wall, at the end, we're going to do a wall set. And so we want to work our quads, the front of the thighs, the hamstrings, the back of the thighs, and the sides. We adduct, go out, and we want to work the inner thighs too as well, and the calves. So we're going to first do it on the side, squats. And you want to make sure your knees don't go in front of your toes to help save the knees. Go as far as you can, and like you're sitting on a seat. And then we're going to do side lunges. Once again, watch that knee over that toe. Do the other side, watch the knee over the toe. And then you can add weights. You want to twice a week add weights, because that helps with toning the muscles too as well. And we're going to do deadlifts where you bend forward, come down. You want to slowly come up. It also helps the lower back too as well. And we're gonna do toe raise, calf raise, and then we're gonna do knee kicks. When you, like you're doing jumping jacks, but you're coming underneath. And once again, that'll help the inner thighs. So DJ Roz, ready when you are. You can do it with or without weights. And do it at your own speed. So we're gonna start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So we're gonna do squats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, 1, oh Lord, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And last, we're going to pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I know you feel it. 9, 10. Get it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Going to rest a little bit by shaking the legs. Get ready for the sidelines. And on 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. To the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, other side, pulse, 1, arch your knees, 3, 2, 5, 4, 3, 5, 6, I want to do the other side again.
Check it out. Going to the pathways. The focus we call 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Relax a little bit. And plug in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Put your weight down. You had heavier weight, still be weight, the light weight for the arms. It's gonna start up. Warm underneath. 2, 3, 4, 5. If you want to do jumping jacks, you can. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then last thing, you can get a wall. If you don't have a wall, just do squats. You're going to do it for 20 seconds.
All right, and stretch out those calves, hamstrings. And throughout the rest of the day, you can do that, and you can do 3 sets. Get your water.
Thank you so much, Dr. Crawford. Thank you. Hydrate, get that water in. You need to get about a gallon in each and every day. We're going to bring up Minister Ernestine Davis for our upper body. But just want to let you know that we have 3 different topical pain creams. We have a 500 milligram, we have a 400 milligram, and we have a Dr. Reader's Raw, which is about 200 milligrams of CBD. What's the difference? Well, you have to try each and every one. I use all 3 at different times. Actually, I love the 500 after the workout because it has more menthol, it has more cooling sensation on my muscles. I like using the 400 at night while I'm sleeping. And then Dr. Rita's Rub, I actually use it during my workout. So find which works best for you. They're all using organic CBD with essential oils to reduce inflammation. So no more biofreeze. No more Aleve, no more Motrin. All of those products long-term can cause Motrin and Aleve can cause kidney failure. We don't want that, right? We want to address our pain in a holistic, natural way. So Ernestine Davis, she's an amazing woman. This woman is a beast, a powerhouse, I'm telling you. And she comes every Wednesday morning with the fire. Are you out there?
Yes.
Ernestine Davis, thank you.
Good morning. Thank you, Dr. Rita, for that wonderful introduction. I am Ernestine Davis, Minister Ernestine Davis, for my team, Lady E-Fit. I brought about 8 ladies with me from the Adulam Journey and Present Your Body Fitness. Just a little bit about what I use for myself, the Power Gummies. I take these after a long workout at night. I do 2 late night workouts, 7 o'clock, we're done at 8, but I'm all wound up. So I need something to kind of pull me down in a good way so that I can just fall asleep and get some rested sleep. And I did try that 8 hours, Dr. Tyus. Unfortunately for me, I think I went too early. 8:30, I was up at 3. So I've been up since 3. couldn't sleep, didn't want to take a gummy because I'm like, maybe I may get some bit too much rest to sleep. And then yesterday I hurt my knee. I was doing a class, a boot camp for the University of Illinois. I teach those guys. So I immediately applied the extreme, the liquid relief. And this is the Dr. Reader's rub. It's wonderful. I rolled it on. I iced it. I wrapped it. I had my knee brace on. And today I was, you know, you're a little reluctant doing those lunges, but I made it through. Didn't feel anything. And feeling great. So you guys know who I am, my team. And a lot of them have, I've sold a few of those, the Legacy conference packs to my team. They're excited. So some of them have picked them up and some are coming in the mail. So you're going to really enjoy the product. So today we're going to be doing upper body, and you're going to need a set of dumbbells. If you don't have dumbbells, canned goods. We're going to be on the floor. We're going to be doing three formats. The first one, we're going to be doing some walking push-ups. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. I'll walk you through it. And then we'll go into some chest compressions. And then we're going to do some dumbbell rows. And I will definitely coach you guys through. So let's get on the floor. So I'll demonstrate the walking push-up. You can do them on your knees or on your toes. If you're on your knees, we're going to go one, two, three, walk, walk, one, two, three, come up, walk, walk, one, two, three, come up, walk, walk. And then we're going to immediately roll over on our back and we're going to do some chest presses. If you have issues with low back or sway back, all you have to do is just bring your knees up. So that way your low back stays on the floor, abs are tight, going right up and right down with a four count. And then the last exercise, you'll need a dumbbell or a canned good. You can do it on your knees or on your toes. You're going to be in a bridge position or a plank position, and then you're going to go underneath and pull that weight through, underneath, pull it through. And here's a bonus. You can do a mountain climber. You can do four of those, or you can run it out. Or you can just stay here and keep rolling it through. Try not to turn your hips. Keep those hips squared. If you're on the floor, again, roll it through. Roll it through. Can't do the mountain climbers. You can just bring those hips up four times and jump back in. When you're ready, Dr. Roz, we're going to start with those walking push-ups. You guys ready? It's all about the timing for me.
Starting session.
You ready? Let's go. One, two, three, up and walk. One, two, three, up and walk. Let's go. One, two, three, up and walk. One, two, three, up and walk. We're ready. You got 10 seconds. And we're going on our backs. Up and walk. Get ready. Flat screen.
Your hands
underneath, either way. All right. When you are ready, Dr. Roz, take it away. You guys ready? Let's go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1. Come on, lean back. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Grab your weights. 4, 3, step, 2, 1. Last pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Again. Push. Squeeze. Come on. Reach. Reach. Give me 4 more. 4, 3. Push. Push. 2, 1. Scissors. Tap. Up. Tap. Tap. Single leg straight. Tap. Stand up. Tap. Step in. Tap. Give me 8 more. 8. Tap. 7. 6. You got this. 5, push, 4, 3, 2, 1, scissors, scissors up, I mean down, bring it up. If you feel anything in your low back, place your hands under your feet, I mean under your glutes. Give me 4 more, that's it, 3, come on guys, 2, and 1, last round. You ready? 4, 3, 2, let's tap. Rock back. Lean with it. Rock with it. For 8, 7, 6, push, push. 4, 3, 2, 1, grab those weights. Last round. 4, chin up. 3, 2, push. Come on, girl. Pulse it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, again, 8, push, 7, push, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, scissors, tap, come on, tap, tap, point that toe, that is heel knee, 4, 3, 2, 1, scissors, come on, up and down, cross them, back up, hup, hup, got this, almost there, 4, 3, 2, guess what, we're done, good job guys, thank you.
What did I tell you? We've got beast of trainers here at Wakana. Oh my goodness, the phone just dropped off the entire apparatus. Thank you, Minister Ernestine Davis. Oh my goodness, it is time to cool it down with mindfulness, meditation, and yoga and stretch with Queen Neff. Queen Neff, are you out there so you can just get our minds right and ready for today? Thank you, ladies.
Wow. Absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. Thank you so much. Woo, coaches, you guys are amazing. Thank you so much for getting me awake this morning, this rising. Wow, let's take some deep breaths in and out. That was a tremendous workout. Thank you, Dr. Rita, for that amazing warm-up. Phenomenal. I love boxing, kickboxing. Gets me going. Feels really great. Opens up the entire body. Thank you so much, Dr. Tyus, for that lower body. Oh my gosh, I needed that. That was powerful. I feel very strong in my body right now. And thank you so much, Coach Ernestine, Minister Ernestine, Coach. I love it. Thank you so much. Nice and strong. My upper body, my shoulders are feeling it. I'm very mindful of the way my body is feeling right now and where I'm feeling those different emotions, where I'm feeling tightness releasing, where I'm feeling my body opening, where I'm feeling stagnant in some areas or where the stagnation is now gone. I am mindful of what my body is telling me right now. So right now, saying relax and let's breathe in. Let's breathe deep and get the oxygen in. So inhale through your nose. Relax your shoulders. And you want to just inhale into the belly like there's a balloon in there. You want to blow that balloon up. So we're going to try, we're going to do some very deep breathing into our lower abdomen right now. So breathe in deep in through your nose. Relax your shoulders down. Don't hunch your shoulders up. Just relax. So anywhere you are, whether you're in a chair, you're sitting on the floor, you're on a medicine ball, maybe you are standing right now. If you're standing, come to a seated position. And let's just relax our shoulders. Relax. Bring your legs out in front of you. You want to find your sitting bones that sit on our bottoms. So when you find your sitting bones, it allows the spine to get erect. So you'll feel it as soon as you find them because it starts to make your back stay straight, just like this. If you're not there, you'll find yourself in a hunched position, but the sitting bones are located directly bottom of the pelvis right now. Might have to lift a little out of the way just to find those sitting bones, but once you find them, it just feels right. Be mindful of your breath, still breathing in and out. I will turn from time to time so you can see exactly what it looks like both sides. Okay? You want to place your hands, the palms of your hands on top of your knees. And let's send the energy up through the body. So as we breathe in, let's inhale up through the front of our body. So just imagine the oxygen coming up through the front, all the way to the top of your head. And then exhale and allow the oxygen to go back down your spine. Come out through your legs, all the way through the legs, out through your feet, bottom of your feet. Exhale. Now let's inhale. Deep into the belly, relaxing the shoulders, holding the breath at the top for just 1 second. Exhale. Allow the oxygen to fall back down the spine, down the back of the legs, out through the feet. Inhale again. You are at your own pace, but make it a nice deep inhale with intention. Bringing oxygen into the lungs and the entire lung. You want to fill the lung space with fresh oxygen. And exhale, open your mouth and ha. Let's do that again. Inhale into the belly, really big, deep, deep, deep. Open up your chest. Hold it at the top for 2 seconds. One, two, holding that breath. Exhale. Really press all the oxygen out. Feel it all the way to the navel to the spine. Just really pressing out that oxygen. Just when you think you're at the end. Inhale. We're starting the engine. Holding the oxygen at the top. Hold your breath. Two. And exhale. Release it down the back of the body, down the spine, down the back of the legs, out through the feet. Exhale. Inhale. Relaxing in the shoulders. Relax the forehead. Relax. Exhale. Inhale again. Inhaling and exhaling like this gives the body regeneration, rejuvenation. Exhale. Invigorates the blood. Keep pressing the oxygen out. Squeeze the navel to the spine. Squeeze your chest down. Compress yourself. And inhale. Hold it at the top. Exhale, allow the oxygen out. Press it out through the body. Really press in the navel. Now let's bring ourselves to standing. So you're going to come to your feet. Make sure you're ready to stand. You have your breath. You're still breathing nice and deep into the belly. Coming up nice and slow. Now let's spread your feet hip width apart. You're going to lift the toes to find the balance between the heels and the balls of the foot. Feel yourself tilting forward. It means that you're leaning forward. Find that balance by lifting the toes. If you feel yourself going backwards, it means that you're leaning back. So lift the toes to find that balance and then lower them down. Engage your thighs by tightening your thighs, lifting the knees, and tuck your pelvis just slightly. You want to squeeze in the abs, lift the chest, and roll your shoulders down and back, squeezing the shoulder blades together and releasing the arms. Your head and chin are in neutral position. You're standing strong in your mountain pose. Standing strong in your mountain pose. Every once in a while, lift the toes to make sure that you have equal balance. Balance in life is important. Breath in life is important. Being mindful of how our bodies feel, moment by moment, is important. It's important for everything that we do. Every decision that we make. Bring in the oxygen into your abdomen now. Inhale deep. Hear the sound of the oxygen going through the throat as you fill your belly. Place your hand on your stomach and exhale. Press the belly in with your hand. Press it. Exhale. Feel the navel go as much as it can to the spine. You want to squeeze in and inhale. And exhale. Drop your shoulders down, relax your neck, relax your head. Let's look side to side, left to right, or right to left. Let's stay to the left. When we get to the left, we're going to stay there. Bring your left hand up. Place it on your chin. And as you place it on your chin, you're going to press your chin to the left with your hand. Releasing the neck, breathing into the abdomen. And we're releasing tension in our neck. So let's think about our neck on our exhale. Think about relaxing the right side. And bring your left hand down and allow your head to come to the front. Inhale again. Nice big deep inhale into the belly. Exhale, turn to the right. Chin leads you to the right. Take your right hand and place it on your chin. You're going to press your chin just a little bit with your hand. Inhale here. exhale, releasing the neck, thinking about releasing the left shoulder, releasing the neck, really opening up that chin, that neck. Bring your right hand down, inhale. Exhale and turn your head to the front. Now let's go side to side with our head. So we're just gonna lean over to the left, releasing the neck, releasing the right shoulder. Inhale and bring your head back up. Exhale and lean over to your right. Just let that left shoulder go. Wonderful. You're in your mountain pose, nice and strong in your legs. Your balance is perfect. Your pelvis is tucked, your abs are nice and strong. Your chest is lifted, shoulders are down and back. Relax your neck. Inhale here. Exhale and go back over to your left again. This time you're going to bring your left arm out. Bend at the elbow and place your hand gently on top of your head. Just right on the side of the head. Just allow the palm to be the weight. Feel the extra stretching on the right side of the neck. Breathe into the belly. Release the tension there. Inhale the arm up. Exhale, let it go. And start to bring the head back up again. Let's do the same thing on the right side. Inhale. Exhale with intention, release. Pull the belly in, pull that navel in, releasing the stomach, really releasing that oxygen out. Let's place the right arm up, inhaling up. Place the right hand on top of the head, right on the side, allowing the weight of the arm just to give you a gentle tension right here, releasing all this area here in the trapezius, in the neck, and in the shoulder. Being mindful of our breath. And release the oxygen. Open the arm and let it come down. And bring the head back up. Now let's go side to side again. So if you feel any tension in your neck or in the shoulders, you can always use your topical, your CBD topical relief. Apply just a small fingertip amount, rub it in, and just place right on the area where you're feeling a little discomfort. We're still standing in our mountain pose, nice and strong. Let's inhale our arms up. As we inhale, we reach out to the side, we reach out, we reach up towards the ceiling. Now, right now, we're just reaching up. I'm stepping back so you guys can see. Your palms are facing forward. Fingers are spread apart. Spread your fingers apart. Reach up towards the ceiling. Reach up really tall out of your ribcage. And let's go side to side on our reach up. So reach up for the right and reach up on the left. It's like you're reaching for a piece of fruit that's hanging from a tree. Let's look up at that piece of fruit and try to reach for it. Really grab and reach up out of your rib cage, out of your side obliques, out of your side muscles, stomach muscles. And release, let go. Turn your palms out and give yourself a big exhale, reaching out for the walls beside you. Bringing your arms out and down, reaching down to the floor. Awesome. Spread those fingers apart. Wiggle your toes and your fingers. Wiggle those toes. Come up on your toes a couple of times. Releasing that stagnation. Come up on the toes a few more times. In your mountain pose, you're just rolling up on the toes and back on the heels. Up on the toes, back on the heels. And release your arms down. Let's inhale up again. Palms touch, exhale. Squeeze the belly in. Squeeze the belly in. Squeeze. Inhale. Exhale. Squeeze. Those arms are still up, nice and tall, reaching up towards the ceiling. Inhale. Reach up. Exhale, turn your hands out. Reach for the walls, stretching out the shoulders, lengthening in the shoulders. Let's clasp our hands behind us. Clasp your fingers behind you, just like this. And you're going to press those arms down below the bottom as you can. Opening up the chest, squeezing the shoulder blades together. Pressing those shoulders down. And let's give ourselves a little bit of arch in the back. Let your chin lead up. And come back down, chin comes down towards the chest. Just release those arms. Feel the sensation in the hands and the arms. Feel the energy generating through the body. Let's do that again. Inhale the arms up. Reaching out. Always movement with intention. Keep breathing in. If you need to stop here to exhale, do so. Now inhale, allow the breath to carry the arms back up. Exhale, your palms touch. Your fingers are spread apart. Really spread your fingers apart. When you get to the top, your hands like this. We're going to open those fingers. Open the fingers. Exercise in the fingers. Bringing them together. Palms at the top. Awesome. Inhale, reach up. Come up on your toes. Exhale, open your arms and come down. And let's do a bend forward. We are in our mountain pose. Bring your hands to your knees so you're here. Nice flat back. Inhale, arms up. Palms touch. The fingers are spread apart. Good job. Exhale, bring those arms back down to the knees, just right to the knees. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, all the way down, past the knees. Let's come to the shins if you can. Flat back. Press the bottom up towards the ceiling. Feeling the stretch in the hamstrings. Lift your toes. Inhale, come back up. If you need to bend your knees, then do so when you come down. So if you need to do this, you can. But give yourself gentle tension here. A lot of people are tight in the hamstrings. So this is a great hamstring stretch. It's actually great for lengthening all the back of the leg. Inhale up. Exhale, come all the way down as far as you can to the ankles if you can. If you need to bend your knees, please do so. Inhale, come back up. Palms touch, really coming down again. Forward bend. You're in our forward bend, hands to the ground if you can. Drop your head and relax your neck. If you're here, drop your head, relax your neck. If you're at your knees, drop your head and relax your neck. Inhale, come back up. Bend your knees. Find your balance. Take your time. Come back up to standing. Palms touch. And then bring your arms out. Exhale down. Awesome. Okay, so let's come back down to the floor again. It's 7 o'clock. So we're going to bring it all the way back down to the mat or to your floor. You can come to an easy pose where you cross your legs. If you like to do lotus pose, you can half lotus, whatever feels good to you. If you're sitting in a chair, just bring your palms to your knees. Sit up nice and tall on your sitting bones. Opened up the neck and shoulders, hamstrings, a nice stretch in the glutes and the calves. Now let's go side to side. So bring your left hand over to your right knee. Give yourself a twist. Make sure you're tall in your spine. Nice and tall. Let's walk your hands back around to the other side. Inhale. Exhale and twist. Right hand to the left knee. Take the left hand to the back of you and twist the body, the upper body. Let's go back around again. We're going to walk around, left hand to the right. Twist, gentle twist. Take the chin with you towards the right shoulder. Exhale all the oxygen out here. Take the right shoulder back a little bit more. Press the right shoulder back. And let's walk it around to the other side. Right hand to the left knee. Standing tall, sitting nice and tall, twisting here. Take the chin with you back towards the left shoulder. Now open that left shoulder a little bit more. Twist into that left shoulder. And walk your hands back towards the front. Palms of the hands on the bottom, on the knees. Today is a beautiful and amazing day. Create what you want to see. Be mindful of the things that you say to yourself and to others. Be gentle with yourself. Allow yourself time to breathe. I challenge you to take 5 deep breaths 5 times today. 5 deep, cleansing, releasing, invigorating, intentional breaths today. 5 times. Thank you so much for joining. It has been an amazing Wednesday. Fabulous fitness with you, ladies and gentlemen. Be amazing today. Namaste.
Namaste. Thank you so much, Queen Neff. Thank you all for joining us each and every Wednesday. Have an amazing day. Remember to breathe. Remember to hydrate. Remember to use your products. And we will see you this evening on our 7 o'clock Why Wakana, on our 8 o'clock webinar. We'll be talking about sciatica and the piriformis muscle. We will see you then. Thank you so much.